guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be chatting about skincare and specifically 10 items that I really love that I feel like will change your skin. And the key with skincare is consistency. Doing it day and night is kind of the hardest part, but the most important. And I will have some skincare videos linked down below if you're trying to tackle your skincare, whether you're trying to figure out what moisturizer will work best for you, what toner, what mask, what SPF. I've got videos on just about everything. That will all be linked down below. But today specifically, I'm talking about 10 products and kind of 10 ingredients that you need to look out for in your skincare if you would like to improve your skin. So let's go ahead and get started. So firstly, before we jump into products, I just want to say, because this is a question that I get probably most often, is what order to apply the products, because it's great when you go out and buy them, but if you don't know how to use them, then you're not going to get the most out of it. So generally the idea is to go from lightest in texture to heaviest. So I start with like a toner or an essence after cleansing, then I'm going to go in with a serum, my moisturizer, and my SPF if it's the day, or an oil if it's night. Eye cream I'll generally do between serum and moisturizer, but lightest to heaviest products, you wanna go from like a serum to an oil, or a serum to an SPF, that kind of thing. Firstly, while we're chatting about SPF, why don't I go ahead and get into that? Because SPF is so important in your routine. This is a great one, but any SPF that you like, of course, it's gonna help protect your skin if you're working on tackling fine lines, wrinkles, signs of aging, of course, dark spots, acne, scarring. You don't want it to like bake into your skin. So I've got a great option for you. This is the Lancome UV Expert Aqua Gel Defense 50. I've talked about this many times, but I think it's a great option for any skin type, any skin tone or color, because it does not have a white cast. It has a broad spectrum SPF 50, which is amazing. You wanna look for about an SPF 30 or above for the face. And this is an all day priming and moisturizing gel with vitamin E antioxidants. So it's hydrating, it's lightweight, but it doesn't give you that white look on your face. It doesn't give you that heavy, greasy feeling. It's good under makeup. And it's oil free, and they say it's invisible as well. You're supposed to reapply your sunscreen throughout the day as well. If you didn't know that, if you have makeup on, perhaps spraying something onto your hand and putting it on your face, or an SPF powder will work, but this is a really, really good option. Equally important to SPF is hydration. They kind of go hand in hand in creating the perfect harmony. So I want to talk about a moisturizer that I really love and an ingredient that I really like. It's ceramides. They're very, very great for your skin and very healing, soothing, hydrating. This is the Indeed Laboratories Canadian brand, their Inceramide Daily Moisture Cream. It has triple action ceramides. It's beautiful. Reminds me a lot of the CeraVe moisturizer. I would say this one feels a little bit richer, but it doesn't feel heavier. Really beautiful, fragrance free as well. And again, great for any skin type. I think you could use this day or night. A great simple moisturizer. This is kind of going to become, like, I always recommend Neutrogena Hydro Boost to those of people who have oilier skin. There's like an Olay richer one that I recommend to people who have drier skin. This will kind of become my like, hey Samantha, I need a moisturizer. I'm probably gonna go towards this one because I just think it's so phenomenal and simple and something that everybody will enjoy. Then speaking of hydration and CeraVe, I think it's important to have a great hydrating serum in your routine. A serum generally are gonna be made of smaller molecules. They're going to be more treatment based in that they're gonna be made to get a little bit deeper and more penetrated into the skin, and they have higher concentrations generally than a moisturizer, because a moisturizer's first goal is to moisturize and then they might have secondary ideas, but the serum is going to be a little bit more of like a targeted item, if that makes sense. So I think having a great hydrating one is really important, especially if you're going to use a moisturizer that has an active ingredient in it. Say if you have a moisturizer with vitamin C or a moisturizer with lactic acid, it's great to have just something simple and hydrating and good for your skin. So this is the CeraVe Hydrating Serum with hyaluronic acid. So you're gonna get ceramides in here and hyaluronic acid. If you're using anything with hyaluronic acid, put it on damp skin. Not only is it gonna make it work better because it helps to seal the water, it holds 1,000 times its weight in water on your face. So you're really actually gonna see a difference. Like, I was blown away when I started doing it on damp skin, but it can actually be detrimental to your skin to put hyaluronic acid on when it's not wet, because it goes to pull water, and if it doesn't have the water to pull or to hold, then it can be detrimental. Not to a point where it's gonna do anything like bad, but you're not gonna get the good out of the hyaluronic acid. So I really love this serum from CeraVe. It's lightweight. It does have a little bit of a lotiony feel, as opposed to a lot of hyaluronic acid serums are really watery. There's another great one from Neutrogena. There's a great one from Inky List. Everybody has a great hyaluronic acid out there, but I love this one from CeraVe. I think it's a great brand. Good for those of you that have sensitive skin and you're getting the bonus of hyaluronic acid less ceramides. Eye cream is one of those things that people really seem to go back and forth on whether or not it's important. If you're looking for like simple hydration, you could probably just bring your face cream up. Generally though, people are looking to tackle fine lines, darkness, discoloration, more intense dryness, and that's when it's important to reach for an eye cream because they're going to be formulated specifically for the areas around the eyes. A lot of people think they're a ruse and they can continue to do that, but I'll continue to love eye creams. So I'm like, whether or not, but there's a lot of great ones out there, and I want to recommend this one specifically because, again, similar to the other hydrating products that I'm recommending, these are easily added into anyone's routine, and there's no caveat of like, if you have this, if you have that, like, this is great for everybody, especially if you don't know where to start, and another Canadian brand that I love. So this is Skinfix Barrier Plus Lipid Boost 360 Eye Healthy Eye Treatment. Really, really nice. Really lightweight, great for day, great for night. It helps to plump the skin around the eye, it helps to hydrate it, and if you have dehydration around your eyes, you may end up having fine lines there that aren't actually fine lines and they're actually dehydration. So you want to make sure to hydrate, or you may just have fine lines and you want to make sure they don't go from fine to the opposite of fine, whatever that is, deeper wrinkles. So I really, really like this from Skinfix. Really, really lightweight. They're also cruelty-free as well. Something else that I think is really important for anybody to incorporate into their routine, it's just a matter of finding out which formula and percentage, is vitamin C. And I've been loving this new one from Neutrogena. This is their Rapid Tone Repair Vitamin C Serum. It has 20% vitamin C, so it's a little bit, it's on definitely on the higher side of vitamin C's. I've got a great new one from CeraVe that's 10%. I've got another one from Youth to the People, 15%. It's going to depend on your skin. I've had absolutely no irritation with any vitamin C, but I thought this one was great. I love that it comes in the capsules. I think it's a lot more fun than it probably is, but it really makes me like excited to put on my vitamin C in the day. Vitamin C is best used during the day. It helps with brightening the skin, dark circles, overall tone of the skin. Everybody can make use of vitamin C. Even if you have great skin, it'll help you maintain your already beautiful skin. I wouldn't know. I've had to build mine, but really nice. This is a lot of vitamin C serum, similar to what I said about CeraVe. This also has a bit of a creamier texture, so if you're used to like really watery serums, this won't be that, but it's really nice, feels good, and it's not heavy or greasy by any means. And this having this higher percentage is really nice for me because my skin is used to a decent amount of vitamin C, so I'm really glad that they came out with something that's a little bit higher percentage, but I haven't had any irritation with it, and it just does such beautiful things for your skin. Up next, I have two products that are a little bit more intense in terms of the ingredients that they have, but the amount of intensity that they bring, it is equated in the amount of change I saw in my skin. These are both killer products is what I'm getting at. The first one is the Drunk Elephant, you knew this was coming, TLC Framboose Glycolic Night Serum. This was my first time experiencing an AHA BHA blend, my favorite term. It has raspberry extract in there too, so you're getting salicylic acid in there, which is the BHA. That's going to get a little bit deeper into the skin, deal with your sebum glands, overproduction of oil, pores, breakouts, things like that. But then you're getting AHA, which is a glycolic acid, and that's going to deal with the surface level of your skin. So it's going to deal with texture, tone, dark spots. So it's kind of a great do-it-all. It's formulated to be used every day. I never found it harsh. I didn't get any irritation. They have the baby facial as well, which is meant to be used once a week. And I actually just picked up from Beauty Bay, I'll link that haul down below, I picked up the peeling solution from The Ordinary, which is illegal in Canada, so I haven't been able to try it, but I really love this. I've tried other AHA BHA blends that I love. This is probably one of my favorites. It helped with texture, tone, oil production, breakouts. It just felt like it did everything. It's a night serum that I would easily put like the Indeed Labs over, and it just did wonders. I really, really love this. Drunk Elephant did come out with a new lactic acid serum if you're looking for something a little bit more gentle. I heard that that's more gentle, but this one is my favorite. The other important thing to consider adding into your routine is a retinol, and you can do that at just about any age. If you're like, say, 25 plus, it's never too early unless you're under 25. You know what I'm getting at? But the thing is, I feel like people think that they don't need to reach for retinol until like a little bit later in life, but it's something that can be useful for everybody, even if you're not seeing signs of aging and you wanted to tackle it being preventative. If you have dark spots, you can have other issues with your skin. That's what I used it for. And I did a whole video on this line. This is the Olay Retinol Max. I'm newer to the Max. I used the original when it came out. Then they came out with this one that's meant to be a little bit more intense than the first one. So I figured I would try this iteration. Fragrance-free night serum. When it comes to the Olay Retinol, you can use the moisturizer or the serum. They both do the same thing. It just kind of depends on how you want to add it into your routine. But retinol is a form of vitamin A. It helps to, like, your cells turn over naturally in your skin, but vitamin A encourages them to turn over faster. It just gives them like a little nudge, like, come on, let's get this wrinkle out of here. So that is why I really, really love this. I saw huge differences in the reduction of my acne scarring. It almost got rid of my acne scarring completely. I didn't have irritation with this. It's got niacinamide in there because it's going to be also hydrating. Really, really so impressed. This was my first real big foray into retinol, and the Olay one is so good. If you have more acne-prone skin, if you have oily skin, and you're looking to deal with any congestion, breakouts, issues with the just overall health of your skin, this is it. Except it's not actually it, because I don't have it here in front of me, because I've used like probably 3 bottles or so. But this is the Paula's Choice BHA Exfoliate, and this is their most popular product. It's kind of a cult favorite skincare product in general, but it does wonders for the skin. It's so, so beautiful. I purchased from Paula's Choice directly from their website, shipped to Canada. I've never had a problem. I think it's about $29, so it's like mid-range in terms of the price. And by the way, on the website, like, I'm just looking this up here to double check. They say like peel, I'm saying peel. None of these products made my face or like skin peel. Don't worry about it. But this is a salicylic acid. It's meant to unclog pores, help with breakouts. It says it also helps with wrinkles, brightens, evens the skin tone. It helps with the shedding, the built up layers of skin. So really, really beautiful. They actually just came out with their own AHA, BHA blend. I've only used that about like a couple of times. So this is definitely my favorite. But I've seen so many people who have acne-prone skin and have had issues and then started using this, and it did wonders for them, and it did wonders for me too. This is definitely newer to me, but an ingredient that I've been loving for my skin and absolutely noticed a difference with is snail mucin. And I've heard of this. I remember when this became like, I'm gonna say I remember when it became a thing, as if I think when I watched the video about this, people were doing this hundreds of years ago to protect themselves. But either way, it became a thing to me a couple of years back, and I was curious about it. I heard great things about this brand from CosRx, I believe is how it's pronounced. They're now sold at Walmart in Canada. I picked it up from, I was gonna say Best Buy, Beauty Bay. I don't know, though, Best Buy has weird stuff on their website sometimes. And then also you can get it from Amazon, someone told me. But either way, this is 96% snail mucin. It's meant to be very, very hydrating and plumping to the skin. I notice an immediate difference when I put this on, but just in general, ever since using this, and I've only been using it for a little while, as you can see, I haven't used that much, but you don't need much. But it really, I really noticed a difference. It was so hydrating, so plumping. It's not gross, I swear to you. Just take it out of your mind that it's snail mucin, because it has no smell. It just feels like a serum. You can peel the label off or put on like something that's more pleasant, you know? But I really, really love this. And like I said, I got it from Yes Style, but it's more readily available in Canada now. And again, this is something any skin tone, any skin type would love, because you can have oily skin and still be dehydrated. Lastly, something that I want to talk about is slugging. And this is new to me, and it's when you take, let's go from snails to slugs. I'm going to read it off of Google here because I wanted to see exactly. Slugging is a K-beauty trend of generously applying petroleum-based product as the final step to your routine to help lock in and seal skincare products overnight, and then washing it off with a cleanser the next day. So that's what I've used this CeraVe Baby Healing Ointment for. There's another one in the US. I follow Makeup for Women of Color? I forget her Twitter. I'll leave her handle down below, but she talks a lot about the CeraVe. Like, she's the one of the ones responsible for CeraVe not being on the shelves. But in Canada, we don't have the particular healing ointment that they do in the US, but the baby is the same as what they have in the US. So that's why I picked this up. I use it on my lips too. It's phenomenal if you have dry skin, dry lips. But what I'll do, I only take less than a pea amount, and you really warm it up in your hands. And after you've put your moisturizer on, you put this on, and it feels wrong. And everybody has issues with petroleum-based products, but in my opinion, that's just fear-based marketing. That's a conversation for another day, because people have been using this forever. How many older women look amazing, and you're like, what did you do? And they're like, Vaseline. We have to listen to them. Just don't do it in the sun. Wear your SPF. But really beautiful. The next day, my skin feels plump. It feels hydrated. You may want to do this like an hour or two before bed. I don't ever do it and then get directly into bed. There's a little bit of a period of it to absorb into your skin. Really beautiful. This product is meant for babies, so it's obviously not going to be irritating, but it helps protect and relieve minor skin irritations. It has ceramides in there, which is what I was speaking about earlier. lanolin free, and it's a skin protectant. It really just, it's like an occlusive, locks everything in. Because I was kind of picking through my facial oils, trying to determine what facial oil I wanted to recommend to you, but none were jumping out to me the same way that this product was in terms of what have I noticed really, really changed my skin, and this is definitely it over a facial oil. There's ones that I love, but if I had to pick and choose, I thought this may be more interesting and impactful perhaps for you to add into your routine, and you'll never run out of this. And if you already have a baby, you can try it tonight. I've also used just straight up Vaseline. You can use straight up Vaseline, and I've used the one from Aquaphor as well. All really, really nice. But this one has the ceramides in it, so I think I like it the best. So that's everything from me. I hope you found this video helpful. I'd love to know down below what product you've used that's really changed your skin, whether you're recommending it to me or just sharing. And as always, if you'd like to connect with me, you can find me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook @SamanthaJaneYT, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.